Hi everybody, my name is Carlos Roberto Chirinos. It's great to be with you. Remember to stay safe by washing your hands and wearing a face mask correctly. Today we are going to talk about first conditional if, past, and would. Let's focus on the class. Take a look at the following situations and what I would do. If I saw an alien, I would run away. What about you? If I won the lottery, I would save the money. What would you do? In this case, we are using the first conditional because we are talking about hypothetical or unlikely situations. En este caso, estamos utilizando el primer condicional, debido a que estamos hablando de forma hipotética, es decir, no estamos seguros que suceda. Let's see some other examples. Class, here we have more examples. Repeat the sentences after me. She would travel all over the world if she were rich. She would pass the exam if she ever studied. If I didn't practice so much, I wouldn't play the piano very well. Class, Holly is an English speaker student who came to the UPMSM for 2 days, so that he's talking about it. This is the conversation he has with his friend. Are you going to rent a house or apartment? If I found a house, I would prefer it. It would be difficult if you went on the weekend. Anyway, I'll be okay. I admire your optimism. If I saw something for you, I would buy it. Okay, class. Now, repeat after me. Comencemos. Are you going to rent a house or apartment? If I find a house, I would prefer it. It could be difficult if you went on the weekend. Anyway, I'll be okay. I admire your optimism. If I saw something for you, I would buy it. Very good. Let's talk in a light way. You are going to be Holly. Let's start. Are you going to rent a house or apartment? It would be difficult if you went on the weekend. I admire your optimism. Excellent. The first conditional is a linguistic structure which is used to express a consequence or result in the future due to a specific hypothetical situation that is being accomplished or not. El primer condicional es una estructura lingüística que se utiliza para expresar una consecuencia o resultado en el futuro, debido a una situación hipotética que se está cumpliendo o no. It has two sentences. The if, which is the condition, in simple past tense, and the main sentence with the auxiliary would, which is the result. Look at the example. If I won the lottery, I would save the money. We can also change the order of the sentence. I would save the money if I won the lottery. Notice, when the if sentence comes second, there is no need for a comma. So remember, to create the first conditional, we should place the if condition at the beginning, plus the statement in simple past tense. This is the condition clause. Then write down the subject, plus the auxiliary would, and the statement in simple present tense. This is the result clause. Look at the example. If the weather was sunny, I would go to the park. Now, it's time to put into practice what we already know. You are getting there. We are going to make some exercises. Say, which of the following statements are grammatically correct? Select just one. A or B. Ahora realizaremos una serie de ejercicios. Seleccionen una de las dos oraciones, la que está escrita correctamente. The first one. Perfect. The correct statement is the letter A. If I found a cheap flight, I would go to Canada. Keep it up. Number two. Excellent. The correct statement is the letter B. She would join us if she had free time. Number three. Yes, the letter B. If the rain stopped, I would go out. Next one. Well done. Letter A. If I came out, I would invite you. Let's continue. Very good. Letter A. If I put salt in my coffee, it couldn't taste good. This is the last one. Great. Letter B. If I saw a ball, I would run away. Never stop dreaming. Never stop believing. Never give up. Never stop trying, never stop learning.